Back at the Mellon Arena, the Pittsburgh Penguins with a 2-0 lead over the Canadiens of Montreal. The Penguins' Sidney Crosby and Mario Lemieux, a story type of first period for the writers and media from the country of Canada. And Bobby, you hail from Canada, and I don't think people really realize they would football here in the United States, but how big of a game and the personnel and the figures involved in this, how big it is for Canadians when you get something like this and that matches up?
Well, you know, everybody back home is watching, Mike, and you can't go through your normal routine. You just can't. You're not going to sleep in the afternoon. The adrenaline is pumping through. You got to worry about being kind of too hyped up for these hockey games. Sidney Crosby, you could see early in the game, he had extra energy in his legs. He had extra adrenaline pumping through, and it was very obvious, especially in those first couple of shifts. He went wide on the first shift. He had a great opportunity. He didn't score, but he does get a goal on a Penguin power play. You know, Montreal Canadiens put a foot in their mouth there with too many men on the ice. And later in the period, Mario Lemieux just leaving that stick on the ice. And Rick Jackman used, you know, Palfy. They pass these pucks so hard that you can just use the pace of that to get it in the cage. And at the other end, Theodore was just tremendous. He was laying out. He stopped Dandonneau on three shots. He stopped Radek Bonk, who was looking for his first goal of the season. Got a little help from his buddy as well, Mike, and you have to.
Yeah, the old post right there to help him out. Shots on goal. Pittsburgh with 10. Montreal with 10. The Penguins with 8. You can see the rest of the numbers there. All right, we'll be back with period number 2 in just a moment.